Greetings. This is video number 2 addressing the treasure trove of Deedat ignorance. In video number 1, I very clearly prove that God's name is Jehovah, or YahWeh. Now here's a great part of that speech by Deedat.
What's his name? Then he would say his name is Jehovah. All right, for a moment we accept.
All right, for a moment we accept. Deedat simply cannot argue with the facts. But Deedat's ignorance never quits. He's about to attempt an argument that is a complete non sequitur. His argument is that Jehovah never appears in the New Testament, while Allah does.
In the 27 books of the New Testament, the word Jehovah does not occur even once. Not once in 27 books. In the original. So what kind of a name is this? If God Almighty inspires his book, why is he ashamed to put his reveal his name?
The non sequitur is that God must include his name in the text.
That means afraid, it's ashamed. Like saying Saddam, my name is Saddam. Anyway, your child, maybe you have named him out of some love for the guy. But as the child is growing, is going to school, it'll be difficult because I'm Saddam. Or in Muslims, I'm Hitler. You don't say, I'm Hitler. Maybe you are an innocent man, you may be a priest, you may be a very kind, saintly person. But say, I'm Hitler. What's your name? Say, Hitler. What's my name? Say, Saddam. No, it's very, very difficult. You see? So now, is God ashamed of his own name? If that is his name, I say, in the 27 books, the word does not occur even once.
Deedat goes on some tirade about Saddam and Hitler as if God is afraid or ashamed of his name, and that's just stupid. What kind of an idiot makes that kind of an argument?
And you say God dictated it? He inspired it? You said yes. Then how is it that his name is not there in the 27 books, not there at all?
The non sequitur is that God must include his name in the text. This seems to be pretty standard Mohammedan behavior. Imagine that God must include his name, then judge God and condemn God for not behaving as you think he should. That's exactly what Deedat does here, and that's exactly what most Mohammedans do with their rationalization and their arguing. Rather than look at the Word of God and accept the Word of God, they would rather judge God. Judge God. Just as Satan wants to set himself above the Most High, those who follow Satan think they too are entitled to judge God. Judge God.
So we said, look, amazing thing. The name Allah is still there. In the 2,000 different languages, the word Allah is They have not been able to eliminate it.
Deedat claims Allah appears in the text. It does not.
Amazing. So where is it? I said, look, you remember when Jesus Christ is supposed to have been on the cross.
The second problem for Deedat is that he's basing his claim on an event that Islam denies even happening. So Deedat is willing to try and trick you into Islam and claim that Allah is mentioned in the Bible in a story that he would turn around and out of the other side of his face say is a fantasy.
According to Matthew and Mark, Luke, in two places, is made to say, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Eli, Eli lama sabachthani. Then I said, listen. Eli, Eli lama sabachthani in Hebrew. Allah, Allah lama taraktani in Arabic. Sound similar? Eli, Eli lama sabachthani. And say, Allah, Allah lama taraktani. Sound similar?
The text is Eli, Eli. Or Eli, Eli. I've heard that pronounced Eli, Eli with long E's, or Eli, Eli with the long E in the second syllable. but the word never is Elah, Elah, which Deedat needs to do to make this word sound like Allah, Allah, Elah, Allah, Elah, Allah. If he can change the word and change the sound, then people who are gullible and don't look at what's written may believe him. And remember that. This is not the word Allah. It is a word Deedat mispronounces to sound like Allah, 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 Elah, Allah. Let's look at the next verse, which is the context. Matthew 27:46. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there, when they heard this, said, this man calls for Elias. Notice what the people there thought. They thought Jesus called out to Elias. Elias, not Allah, Allah. Elias the prophet, not Allah, Muhammad's spook. Mark 15:34. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And some of them that stood by, when they heard it, said, behold, he calleth Elias. Eloi, 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 not Elah, not Allah, not Elah or Allah, Elah, Allah, it's Eloi. Again, notice what the people there thought. They heard it. They know. They thought Jesus called out to Elias, not Allah. So remember, the word that Jesus says, the word in the Bible, is not Allah. And the people who were there did not think it was Allah. So this is not the word Allah. This is just another example of Deedat changing the word of God. So do not listen to Deedat's lie that the word Allah appears in the Bible. Do not listen to any Mohammedan when they repeat this lie. You decide if he was a liar or just so ignorant that it defies human understanding. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.